Hi, I'm Jim Covington. Today is May 21st, 2015. I'd like to welcome you to this week's issue of ISBA Statehouse Review. Talk to you about four different bills, but I'd like to talk to you about an issue that kind of popped up yesterday at a press conference in Springfield. The Taxpayers Federation of Illinois and the Center for Tax and Budget Accountability issued a joint issue brief on a proposed service tax in Illinois. It was these two organizations, both of whom are respected in tax policy, how Illinois should go about adopting a service tax. And I've included on your screen in the PDF a link to that issue brief, which is short. It's less than about 12 pages, but in it it recommends that the majority of professional services should be excluded from any such service tax as part of the Illinois sales tax base. And it's kind of one of the, it essentially, I believe, validates the position we've taken on that. And it's something I'd recommend you take a look at. The first bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 3672, introduced by Representative Greg Harris from Chicago and Senator Bill Cunningham from Chicago. And it amends the county's codes to allow a county that has a property fraud alert system to allow the county recorder to create a registration form to register a property owner on the county's property fraud alert system. A real estate professional may file the registration form with the recorder on behalf of the property owner. Provides the property owner may have three other people to receive the fraud alert when on his or her registration form. That's passed the House and is awaiting a vote in the full Senate. The next bill is amends and completely rewrites the Illinois Parentage Act. It's House Bill 1531, introduced by Representative Kelly Burke from Evergreen Park and Senator John Mulro from Chicago. And it's modeled after the Uniform Act, but made Illinois centric. It has passed both chambers, and the procedure is after both chambers pass the bill, then the General Assembly has 30 days within to send it formally to the governor, and then the governor has 60 days to take some kind of action on the bill. The next bill I'd like to talk to you about is awaiting a full vote in the Senate after passing the House and the Senate Criminal Law Committee. It's House Bill 1446, introduced by Representative Elaine Nekritz from Buffalo Grove and Senator John Mulro from Chicago. Currently under Illinois law, any person has a four DUI convictions is prohibited from ever driving again, period, no exceptions. This bill retains that prohibition from getting full driver privileges back, but it permits this person to ask the Secretary of State for a restricted driving permit after a five-year period from the last conviction or incarceration. It would require the driver to go through an extensive evaluation by the Secretary of State and to permanently use a bay device to drive for certain limited purposes. The person will never be eligible for reinstatement of full driving privileges. And that's been endorsed by the Mothers Against Drunk Driving and the Alliance Against Intoxicated Motorists. The final bill I'd like to talk to you about is Senate Bill 804. It amends the Court Security Fee Act and the County's Code. It's introduced by Senator Bill Hain from Alton and Representative Don Moffitt from Galesburg, and it allows a court security fee to exceed $25 for every party in a civil suit if it is set according to an acceptable cost study under the county's code. The fee is also currently, and this would, and the bill would apply to it, added to a plea of guilty or conviction for defendants in traffic ordinance and criminal cases. That bill has passed both chambers. Thank you for listening. We've got about two more weeks of regularly scheduled session, or 10 days, and then they're scheduled to adjourn. Not sure what's going to happen here on the big ticket items, including the budget, but we'll talk to you again next week about those things. Thank you.